If you don't own a console and obviously plan on playing GTA 6, you need to watch this video. We're going to be talking about some important stuff that you need to know about and a whole lot more. So as I'm making this video, Grand Theft Auto 6 and its first trailer just hit 180 million views, which is just insane. Let me know in those comments down below how many times you have watched the trailer, because I know I've contributed probably a couple of hundred views to that. Have you watched it once? Have you watched it 10 times? Over 100 times? Let me know in those comments down below. It'll be interesting to see overall how many views it gets, but also number two, how many views it gets before another trailer arrives. That'll be interesting to see as well. But that is just a wild number, 180 million views in just over 3 months. That feels crazy to say. Fans definitely want GTA 6 to get here. But anyways, let's move on. There was some interesting discussion going on a thread by a user, Green, who said, "I don't own a console. 2025 sucks." And they said, "I'm a longtime PC gamer, but GTA 6 being on Xbox and PlayStation 5 exclusive for the first year is probably the only reason I'd get a console. However, the timing is terrible. The next generation of consoles is set to be released in 2027/2028, meaning us who don't own a console won't just be buying one exclusively to play GTA 6, we'll be buying one just a couple of years before they become old gen. Is anyone else in the same position? What will you be doing? Buy a soon-to-be old gen console or hold out for the PC release?" And you guys can respond to Green as well in those comments down below. It is an interesting situation, and it's an interesting situation even if you do have the current generation consoles, Xbox Series X or S and PlayStation 5, because we are so close to the end of its life cycle. And we will be talking about the pro version towards the end of this video, but this prompted Insider Tez Funds 2 to respond to a comment that was made a few weeks later. Someone said, "As someone that is primarily a PC gamer, I'm right there with you that I'm hoping they change their stance on this topic. But whether they do or don't, it's their call and they know more than we do. That's all I've been saying." With Insider Tez Funds 2 saying their stance is primarily technical. The PC version is falling behind in terms of progress. It isn't as stable as the console builds, more crashes. They aren't going to delay the console versions just to give off the impression of them releasing the PC version on day one. Waiting for PC may push the game into 2026. Additionally, you don't want to release the PC version day one in a buggy state and end up as a new addition to the dislike trend among the gaming community of publishers releasing buggy and unoptimized PC releases and ports. And you have Red Dead Redemption 2's PC version, which was released a year later and was still buggy on launch day. So it would have been worse if it had released a year prior, which wouldn't have been a good move to convince customers to double dip. And at this stage of development, increasing resources towards PC means lowering focus on console builds, increasing the likelihood of internal delays, and the primary reason behind the leadership pushing hard for a forced return to office is to avoid that. So essentially, there's a lot of factors at play here, but it almost just seems like it isn't worth it for Rockstar. And there's probably a lot of reasons for why it isn't worth it for Rockstar. And there's some that we probably just won't know, but they have always been a console-first company. In fact, some of their titles aren't even on PC. One of the best titles of all time, Red Dead Redemption, still not on PC. And I feel like they do it just to kind of say, okay, fine, we're going to do it. We'll put the game out on PC. But it truly does feel like Rockstar would almost rather just straight up develop their games for the consoles. And I don't think GTA 6 is going to be any exception here. And Rockstar, again, doesn't want to do anything that isn't perfect, or at least try not to do something that isn't perfect. And I feel like ultimately they have less control on the PC, which is why they don't put as much effort into that. However, PC platforms typically allow for better performance, superior graphics, and that's one thing that the pro version of these consoles are hoping to get at least a little bit closer to that PC level. But unfortunately, it doesn't look like the PlayStation 5 Pro, at least according to a new article, is going to be expected to deliver 60 FPS for GTA 6. So the PlayStation 5 Pro, since it's been rumored and announced, has been tied to Grand Theft Auto 6, and even people in the industry have said that Sony is likely to release it just so that they have the most superior console to play Grand Theft Auto 6 on. But unfortunately, the PS5 Pro performance shouldn't be expected to double the frame rate in GPU-limited scenarios over the PlayStation 5 based on specs alone. In a new video that Digital Foundry released, they commented on the rumored hardware refresh from Sony and the level of performance that should be expected out of it, saying it's difficult to predict as of now based on the rumored specs alone. So I'll leave a link to that article in the description if you guys are interested. Long story short, it doesn't look like the PlayStation 5 Pro is going to guarantee that Rockstar Games will be able to get 60 FPS of Grand Theft Auto 6 from day one. That might be something that they're only able to achieve on, let's say, a complete next-gen version, which would be the PlayStation 6. That feels wild to say, but we could only be 3 or 4 years from that actually happening. And last but not least, where I want to end today's video, I literally saw this image the other day. It is a pirated PlayStation 2 version that's rated T for teen of GTA 6. And you guys can see there that it's literally just a basic CD-ROM with GTA 6 written on there. And I wish I could tell you that this was fake. This is a legit thing. It's a modded version of GTA Vice City with characters that look like Jason and Lucia, features from Grand Theft Auto 5, like the character switching overhead camera. Apparently, there's already versions of pirated Grand Theft Auto 6 out there. I don't know where I ended up seeing this video. I think it's all over social media right now, but long story short, just be careful out there. Obviously, there has been no official release yet from Rockstar, and even if it did, it wouldn't come out on the PlayStation 2. It would absolutely not be able to run on a system like that. But anyways, let me know what you guys think in those comments down below. I would love to hear from you guys down there on everything we discussed in this video today, from the PlayStation 5 Pro to not owning a console to the PC version to the really strange PS2 version that's been making its way around in some countries. Again, let me know what you think in those comments down below. I'd love to hear from you guys down there. If you guys did go on to enjoy this video though, a like rating would of course be awesome. And be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new. You want to stay up to date on all the GTA 6 videos that I'll be doing here on my channel. And be sure to ring that notification bell as well. Sometimes YouTube just doesn't work, and if you ring that bell, you'll always be guaranteed to be notified when new videos arrive. But of course, as always, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.